This is an ultrasonic sensor, and in today's video I'm going to explain everything you need to know about it. I will show how it works, how to assemble the sensor on Arduino and ESP32, and at the end we will make two alarm systems. The first one is set up over the Arduino platform. It triggers a buzzer every time an intruder gets close to the sensor. The next will be built using an ESP32 board. In this case, the alarm will send an email every time it's triggered, so you'll know whether there is an intruder when you are far away from your home.
But before you get your hands dirty and making those nice projects, let's start with the basics. What is an ultrasonic sensor and how it works?
The ultrasonic sensor is a device that can measure distances using sound waves. It works in a similar way than bats and dolphins, by emitting sound waves and letting them bounce back. The sensor consists of two primary components, a transmitter and a receiver. The transmitter is responsible for emitting a high-frequency sound. In essence, ultrasonic refers to frequencies beyond the range of human hearing, so something higher than 20,000 Hz. When the sound wave hits an object, it bounces back like echo. This returning wave is detected by the receiver. Using code, we can write a program that will store the timing between those two events into a variable. Then we use this information to calculate the distance between the sensor and the object.
You may be thinking, how can we find the distance if all we know is the timing?
Well, as you know, velocity is distance divided by time. Based on this equation, if we multiply the velocity by the time, we will find the distance. I told you the sensor emits sound waves, so the velocity we need is the speed of sound in air. But if we multiply this speed with the time we found, you'll discover a value that is twice the real distance. That happens because the sound hit the object and came back. In other words, it traveled the same path twice. Then, to find the real distance, multiply the speed of sound with the timing and divide the result by 2.
Now that you understand the principles behind the ultrasonic sensor, let's see it working on an Arduino project and then on an ESP32.
Our first project will be an alarm system using Arduino. If you don't have all components or would like to test before assembling anything, I created a simulation of this alarm system on Tinkercad. You can run it directly on your browser. Just visit the link I've put in the description below. Moving on, for this project you need an Arduino board, a breadboard, a bunch of jumper wires, a buzzer, and an ultrasonic sensor. Firstly, attach the ultrasonic sensor and the buzzer on the breadboard. Then connect the VCC and GND pins on Arduino 5V and ground ports. After that, connect the trigger pin to port 9, the echo pin to port 10, and the buzzer to port 8. Also attach the buzzer GND to Arduino GND. At the end, upload the alarm system Arduino file that I provided. Link is in the description. And now our alarm system is finished. But before seeing it working, I would like to explain the code. At first, we define the constants and variables we'll need. Then, at the setup function, we configured some important aspects of the code, like defining the echo pin as input and the trigger and buzzer pins as output. We also started the serial communication, and it will be important to visualize the distance being measured. At the end, there is the loop function. It starts by turning on the emitter and then activating it for 10 milliseconds before turning it off again. This piece of code will generate the wave sound that will be bounced back by the near object. At line 28, we find how much time the sensor took to detect the echo. This information is crucial for calculating the distance at line 29. In this case, we found the distance in centimeters. After that, from lines 30 to 35, we print the distance. The last part of the code is an if statement that turns on the buzzer when the object is at 15 centimeters or closer from the sensor. In case this statement is false, the buzzer turns down. And now it's time to see whether it will work. So upload the code to your Arduino board and have fun. You might have observed that this project is fairly straightforward. One limitation is that the only method to confirm if the alarm has been activated is by listening the buzzer. However, if you are far away from the system, there is no way to know what is happening. To overcome this problem, we could send a notification to the user, like an email saying, "Your alarm has been triggered." Unfortunately, most Arduino boards have no internet connection by default. That's why I decided to use the ESP32 for the next project. If you don't know what is an ESP32, I'll give you a brief introduction. The ESP32 board is a microcontroller like Arduino. However, it works faster and has more memory, pins, and a PCB antenna that allows the board to connect to Wi-Fi and Bluetooth devices, making it suitable for Internet of Things applications. In the next project, we'll recreate the alarm system, but instead of using Arduino, I'll use an ESP32 to send emails to the user every time the sensor detects something. To assemble this new project, you'll need 3 tiny breadboards, a bunch of jumper wires, a buzzer, an ESP32 board, and an ultrasonic sensor. Start by attaching the ESP32, the ultrasonic sensor, and the buzzer to the breadboards like this. Then connect the VCC and GND pins to VIN and ground ports. At the end, connect the trigger pin to D25, the echo pin to D26, and the buzzer to D19 and GND pins. The assembly is finished. Now it's time to upload the code. But before doing so, I would like to explain it a little bit. This time, I didn't use the Arduino IDE to write the program, but the Tony IDE. The ESP platform can be easily programmed using the Arduino language or Python. When building something from ESP32, I prefer to work with Python. That's why I use the Tony IDE, one of the best IDEs to write Python scripts for microcontrollers. I won't explain how to install the Tony IDE or set it up. If you need help with this step, I recommend you read and follow the instructions of this article. Link is in the description. Now back to the video. If you visit this project repository on GitHub, you'll notice 4 files inside a folder called code. Let's start with the first file that will run when your ESP32 is powered up, the boot.py. On this script, there is a bunch of code that connects your ESP32 board to your local Wi-Fi. You just need to update the SSID and password variables with your credentials. The next file I'm going to explain is the ultrasonicsensor.py. This script contains a class called ultrasonicsensor. In this class, we define the attributes and methods of the object that represents the ultrasonic sensor. So this class contains a function that controls the wave emission and another one that gives the distance in centimeters. The next script we will analyze is the umail.py. That's pretty interesting because it's what allows our board to send emails. The MicroPython, that is a version of Python for microcontrollers, doesn't have any tool to send emails by default. However, there is a project called umail that adds this functionality. You just need to upload the umail.py file they provide and call the SMTP object. Now let's see what is happening in the last and most important file, main.py. In this script, we defined the ultrasonic sensor object. Later, you'll use it to get the distance. If the distance is between 2 and 15 centimeters, you'll play a siren song and then call the send email function, passing all information required to send our message. Now, if you look at the send email function, you'll notice that sending messages requires some special parameters. Let's take a look at each one of them. The first one is the provider. I've already set up 3 providers, Gmail, Outlook, and Live or Hotmail. The next parameter is the sender email. It's the email address that you use to send the message. I highly recommend you don't use your personal email address, because if the system sends lots of messages, your provider will probably block you. So create an email just to use in this project. After the sender email, we have the sender name. That is the name of the app password you've defined on your account. I know I didn't explain anything about it yet, but keep this information in your mind. The sender name is the name of the app password. More about it later. Next, we have the sender app password. As the name suggests, it's the password of your app password. As I told you, more about it later. The next parameter is the recipient email. It's the email address that the message will be sent to. After that, we have the subject of the email, and then we add the message. Now that you understand the code, it's time to explain what is the app password and why you need it. In order to allow ESP32 to access your email and therefore send a message, you need to set up an app password. App password is nothing more than an email setting that allows you to log in a simpler way. Instead of using the password you defined when created your account, you will activate the app password and generate a 16 characters password. Then you use this new password to access your account remotely. In this case, throughout the ESP32 board. The app password activation depends on your email provider. I'm going to explain how to do it on Gmail. So if you are using another provider, let's say Outlook, just search how to activate the app password on Outlook and follow the steps they provided. Firstly, create a new Gmail account. As I told you, don't use your personal account, but open a new one just for this project. After you did it, you need to go to the security page. So type myaccount.google.com/security and you'll see something like this. Scroll down until you find how you're signing into Google. Look at the options. You should see an option called app password. However, if it isn't available to you, go to the search bar and type app password. Click on the option that says app passwords security. You will be redirected to another page. To create a new app password, type the name of the app password on the app name field. In this case, I'll name it ESP32 and then click on create. Later, the system will show you the password. Copy it without removing the spaces. On the main.py file, assign the app name to the sender name variable and the app password to the password variable. The code is now finished. Upload the 4 files to your ESP32 and see what will happen.
That's it for today's, guys. We built 2 incredible projects that helped us understand how the ultrasonic sensor works. I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot. Now, don't forget to click on like and subscribe to the channel so you won't miss any new video. Thank you for watching to the end, and I'll see you in the next video very, very soon.